Welcome back, everybody, and today we're going to be talking about the Lulzbot Mini. Let's start with specifications. So, this is a PEI print surface bed with, it is a 6-inch by 6-inch by 6-inch, I believe, 6-inch in Z axis. What should I start with? Let's talk about the extruder. So this is a version 2, which means you can identify them by the fan in the front. On the version 1, there is no fan in the front. This is a fan for the extruder itself, not the parts. On the version 1, this is a version 2 extruder. The version 1 does not have that fan. So the extruder is made up of a stepper motor, an idler, which you pick up to replace filament. I've heard that the version 1s actually break more. The mini itself is actually a pretty compact design. It's easy to take around. Cable management is pretty decent here. I really like it. This is the electronics box over here. The power button, of course, but I do not have it connected right now. Now, what most people don't like is that you have to run tethered with this printer, so you have a cable for USB, and I'm fine with that because right by my computer here, I put my printer. As you can see, this is kind of getting off topic, but I'm going to be redoing this area in the meantime. Actually, most of these parts are 3D printed, so like the arm is 3D printed for the spool. This green arm, I actually did not come with this printer. I printed myself. It works a little bit better than the other arm seen right here.
Go.
Now we're going to talk about what comes with this printer. So with this printer, you get a blade for removing prints. I personally use this sometimes, but it doesn't really work too well. I kind of have to sharpen it. Some people don't enjoy it because it's too sharp, but I disagree. We have some tweezers to remove small parts. A dental tool to clean the blade thing and the, sorry, I don't know what it's called, inside the extruder. And a metal brush. Now let's talk about functionality. So, of course, this printer is very compact and easy to take around. That's one. Two, just thinking there. This does self-calibrate. So, see these four points? It touches on these one time and then a second time slowly to get the point. And it is an electrical conductor, so that's how it tells it, the extruder. So the nozzle does it itself. And that's how it calibrates. So before it does that, it actually cleans itself in case there's extra filament left on it from the print before. On this very nice thing. Joel, the 3D printing nerd, actually has a review on this printer too, so if you want a better review than mine, just check his channel out. And these wiper blades work really well, he enjoys it. Now, some expensive parts here are the runners for cables. They are plastic, but I believe some YouTubers have said that they are metal. Now let's talk about the prints and print availability on this printer. So, this was an octopus that came with the printer. It printed exceptionally well. They actually printed this as a test print on my printer when it was in the factory, and it came out nice. This is their official Rocktopus. This is on high quality in the quick settings, and this was on standard. And the Rocktopus, of course, his arms came out really nice. And it's very, very smooth. And of course, the Benchy. Now these two are in Polylite PLA green, while this is an NGen filament from ColorFab. And this still came out really well. So I printed this NGen at 210 degrees Celsius on the hot end and 85 degrees Celsius on the bed. This is teal Polylite PLA on my Satisfying Twist. You can check out my Satisfying Twist with a Twist video in the on my channel. Now the quality here is pretty decent, but I got this off of Tinkercad, and I think the reason why there's this shiny, weird triangle texture on it. Thanks for watching, everybody. Please subscribe and comment down below what you'd like to see next. Goodbye.